world is filled with humans of different shapes and sizes, and sometimes I wonder why we don't get to talk more about plus size models. Okay, so would you say that the perception of plus size models in Africa is different from other parts of the world? Like the acceptance, the perception, what people think, what people say about plus size models. Do you think it's different on this side? Do you think it's harsher on this side compared to the other side?
Well, I've not been abroad. I've not been plus size abroad. Although I have traveled like abroad once and I didn't get that body shame or whatever.
But like you do here.
Yes, like compared, like I walk on the streets and people are looking at me, insulting and all that. So
I feel it's harsher here. I feel over there, like everybody they have accepted the whole being plus size thing, but here it's very hard.
I think it's still quite new. Like,
Being a plus size
model coming out and like,
I think
it's still new.
True.
Compared to them, and I think like over there they have like this acceptance, you can wear whatever you want to wear.
Yeah, naturally.
Compared to Nigeria.
You can identify as anything you want to identify.
Now I like that.
You both have a strong presence online, especially Instagram. I mean, even people who are not plus size models, who are not able to do anything special or trying to be anything special, get trolled. So I'm trying to imagine how that situation is for you and other plus size models that are here. Like, what's it like? Like, do you have trolls? Like, really negative, stupid trolls, or it's just they're just very normal, nothing for you?
I've had a couple more, like not much actually, so just a few, and one actually came to comment on my phone now, like, but Risky is better than me body wise. Now, like, who tell that to you?
That's what you said. First of all, there's nothing wrong with Bob Risky, so but coming to someone's page to say that,
even
wow.
No, I like block them, but this time I just leave them. They should just be there engaging on my phone. Give me my engagement, please. Go ahead, continue with your comments. It doesn't affect, so nothing.
Wow, do you have any story that can beat that?
Okay, so I have this Instagram page with my friend, plus size advocates, and when we started about a month ago, we're not like very, you know, just started. There was this lady that commented. She was like, we posted a video and I was like, just vibes. And this lady commented,
what is just vibes?
Like, no, like we're just dancing and just, you know, catching cruise, like, exactly. No one. Okay, so she now commented, I beg, na fat, which kind, what is paparazzi? No, na fat. And I just laughed. I said, wahala for who, no fat. But generally, I've not like had such experience, basically.
Human beings can just be crazy. Anyways, we'll be taking a short break here right now. When we come back, we've got a lot of things to talk about, including your plus size advocacy page.
Right.
That's something quite interesting. So yeah, let's go on the short break. We'll be back. Yes. Traditional models are always being pressured to eat a certain kind of meal, to look a certain type of way for a certain type of job. Have you ever experienced something like that, where maybe a gig is coming and then they're saying, okay, you know what, for this you have to lose 10 pounds, you have to lose 30 pounds, you have to do this, you have to do that. Like, has that ever happened to you before?
What's the point of being plus size model if I have to lose weight?